Hi, I'm Dr. Vimi, specialist dermatologist. Today I'll be discussing about male pattern baldness or androgenetic alopecia. Why androgenetic? Because androgens or the male hormones are responsible for thinning of the hair and early shedding of the hair, eventually leading to bald patches on your scalp. Pattern baldness because it's in a pattern that you develop hair loss. In the beginning, there will be receding of the hairline in the front, leaving a small area of loss of hair in the front. Sometimes the whole area, there will be loss of hair, and then eventually you develop a bald patch on the behind your scalp, and these two patches fuse together, leaving an area of hair behind the scalp and below your ear. So this is the area called the donor area. So this area, the hair will lose only in the late stages of hair loss, and from this area that during hair transplantation the hair will be taken and transplanted to areas of complete loss of hair. So suppose if you have male pattern baldness and then you don't know to which stage you belong to and what are the treatment options that you can try, in this video I'll give you a rough guideline as to how it can be done. Now, look into the picture. The male pattern baldness is staged from stage 1 to stage 7. Suppose you don't know to which stage you belong to, take a picture and just compare with the picture shown in the video. So, it's showing complete loss of hair. But in your case, there will be a complete loss of hair or you have thinning of the hair. The areas of the baldness is seen because the hair is very thin that you can see your scalp through the hair. So if there is complete loss of hair, then there is no scope for medical treatment. There you need hair transplantation and then only you'll get a good improvement. The areas where there is thinning of the hair, the hairs are there but in varying thickness, there is a role for the medical treatment. So what are the medical treatment options? First is a PRP, the plasma treatment, wherein we take the blood and then take the plasma and inject it onto your scalp, which improves it will stimulate the hair follicle for the new hair to come out and improves the thickness and texture of the hair. Second treatment is minoxidil. It's a topical spray that you can put it on your scalp, spray it on your scalp on a daily basis, which helps in stopping the hair fall and improving the thickness of the hair. And also a tablet called the finasteride, which stops the androgen response to the follicle for the thinning of the hair. So all the three medical treatments will work in three different ways, that it will help in retaining the existing hair and make the existing hair more thicker, and also the new hairs, the dormant follicles, will be stimulated by the PRP treatment, wherein new hairs will also come out. So this is how it's being done. So as I told you, the stage from the male pattern baldness is staged from stage 1 to stage 7. Suppose if complete loss of hair, then you need a hair transplantation. Again, hair transplantation has to be done very early. When the donor area is completely gone, then there is no scope for hair transplantation also. So, and then again, when you get a desired result with these medical treatments, as I've told you, sometimes some people will do the PRP and the minoxidil, or PRP, minoxidil and finasteride. These are the combination treatments that you can do. And you will get a desired improvement. The hair thickness has improved and the hair fall has stopped, but you shouldn't be stopping with it. So you have to maintain it because it's a genetic inheritance. So whatever the male pattern baldness, it's a genetic inherited problem where you have inherited it from your father's side or mother's side, and that is there in your body. As long as the genetic inheritance is there, the tendency is there. So the moment when you stop with all the treatments, suppose if you are in a stage 2 or 3, you have a tendency to go into stage 4 or 5. So with this treatment, we are retaining the hair and stopping the hair fall, and that result has to be maintained throughout your life so that the hair will be retained. Otherwise, you will go in for, so this is an always question that being asked, like whenever they come for a PRP and minoxidil, so how long you have to do it. So PRP, I always tell the patient 3 to 6 sessions to begin with, 3 sessions once in every 4 to 5 weeks, and then twice or thrice a year thereafter has to be maintained. Similarly, minoxidil to begin with, it should be on a daily basis, then alternate days, or 3 times a week has to be, you have to continue with that so that you can retain the desired the results that you have obtained from these treatments. Thanks for watching. Thank you.